cover story, our weekly political news magazine. This week, as rumors of Priyanka Gandhi began to do the rounds, we take a look at the importance of Priyanka Gandhi within the Congress. We are also introducing a new section this week called Off the Record. This will bring to you all the delicious political buzz from the corridors of power. But first, as the interview of the week, we speak to Ajit Jogi, the Congress party's best face for the Chhattisgarh elections. We also ask him why, despite being the best face, the Congress is yet to declare him as its chief ministerial candidate. Mr. Jogi, welcome to NewsX, and also you have a very strong challenge ahead of you, the Chhattisgarh Assembly elections, where the Congress is not facing on a very strong wicket, is it?
That's not true. I think in Chhattisgarh, Congress is strong, and nobody should have any doubt that we'll emerge victorious with a thumping majority.
Okay, then my next question, who will your chief minister be?
You know how my party acts in this regard. After the MLAs are elected, they'll sit together, observers will be sent from here, they'll report back to Honorable Congress President, and then she'll decide. So we cannot predict, or we cannot say who the chief minister would be.
But who is the leader of the Congress campaign? You know, it's a very faceless campaign against a very strong leader on the other side.
That's how Congress functions.
Not always. In Madhya Pradesh, you have Jyotiraditya Scindia. In even in Rajasthan, you already have a chief minister. So there is...
No, that's not true.
All the other camp states have a face.
I don't think that's true of Madhya Pradesh. You can't say that so-and-so would be the chief minister. There are leaders like Mr. Kamal Nath, Jyotiraditya Scindia.
But making him campaign committee chief puts him first among equals, doesn't it?
You can't really say that, but he is important. But nobody can say for sure that who would be the chief minister in Chhattisgarh or in Madhya Pradesh, or for that matter, I'll say even in Rajasthan.
Well, even in Delhi, we asked Sheila Dixit and she says party will decide, so Congress really
likes to... That's how we act.
Act of blackmail, isn't it?
No, it's not
political blackmail.
That's how the party has been functioning for these years, long years.
But coming back to Chhattisgarh, where do you stand, Mr. Jogi? It's told that you were very unhappy, that, you know, you also talk of you being sidelined by the party leadership. Where does Ajit Jogi stand today in the Congress?
I don't go public about the internal party matters, but I would like to say that I'm quite happy.
You're happy now, but if I may go by the fact that, you know, you were unhappy, the Congress was scared that you might split the party. Ajit Jogi is a powerful factor in Chhattisgarh, but the Congress was not admitting that for a while.
These were just rumors.
You're not threatening to split the party?
I never thought of it. And everybody knows my relationship with the first family of the country. I'm very sentimentally attached to that family, especially to Srimati Sonia Gandhi. She has done so much for me. Her husband Rajiv Ji, who inducted me into politics, and she, who made me chief minister, gave me so many other assignments. So it's a personal loyalty more than anything else.
But Mr. Jogi, you know how the Congress works. You are
gave me so many other assignments. So it's a personal loyalty more than anything else.
But Mr. Jogi, you know how the Congress works. You are close to the first family, but there are other people also who are trying to trip you up. You know, it's well known that you and, for instance, the general secretary of in charge of Chhattisgarh, B.K. Hari Prasad, don't get along. You've had public spats.
Once again, these are our internal party matters. We shouldn't go public about it, but I can say on record that Mr. Hari Prasad and I, we have been friends for the last 25 years, and there is nothing wrong between the two of us.
But there is, you know, within the party, for instance, why were you not made the PCC chief? Is there a people faction out to get you? Do you feel that there is a lack of trust? What is the issue here?
Within the party, these things are bound to be there.
So there's no fear that Jogi might break up the Congress and walk off with a chunk of MLAs?
This is all speculation. Nothing more than that.
I'm not getting anything more out of you today. Okay, we're moving on from that. You know, what is the biggest challenge for the Congress in Chhattisgarh, apart from the challenge of Ajit Jogi?
There is no challenge of Ajit Jogi. The challenge is not much. Dr. Raman Singh's rule for 10 years has given us enough material, enough issues to
like go what? To the people. Because he's done some lot of good work also. What will you take him on?
This is all media hype, I would say, with due respect to media and to you and to your colleagues. If you go at the ground level, you just give one example. You see the Maoists. During the Congress rule up to 2003, when I was the chief minister, the Naxalites were confined to our borders. They were not inside the territory of Chhattisgarh state. But now almost two-thirds of the state is engulfed by the Maoists.
But look at the welfare schemes. He's implementing the Food Security Act better than the Congress itself has planned it.
I think this is also more on your computers and more on paper. If you go to South Bastar, if you go to the interior tribal villages, you'll find not a grain of rice reaches them. It's all black marketed. But on their computer, the online thing shows that so many quintals have reached such and such village and they have been distributed, which is not correct at the ground level.
But speaking of the Naxal attack, there was a lot of rumors about your role in the recent attack on the Congress leadership. I know you very vociferously disregarded those, but where did these rumors start from? Because a lot of them came from within your party.
Yeah, I think the BJP pounced on it, but I don't deny that there were perhaps some elements within the Congress who have been my detractors for a long time. They thought that this was a good opportunity to encash on it.
But is there some signal gone from the leadership to stop these detractors from speaking against you? Do you feel some, because you were going to deny it, but we all know that you were very upset and ready to split the party. Something held you back. What was that?
No, I was upset after all this happened. But I never thought of going to that extreme, that I'll split the party or I'll leave the party.
How do you see your role, Mr. Jogi, at the center or the state level?
It will depend on the high command. They have to decide where they want to use me.
Are you going to be contesting the elections, assembly elections?
It will also depend on them, whether they want me to contest the assembly or they want me to contest the Lok Sabha, or they do not want me to contest either.
So you will be like the chief campaigner, because they cannot ignore you in the elections. You will be playing a role.
I would be a campaigner, and you can call me the chief campaigner because.
But not the campaign committee chief.
That formal designation has not been given to me, but I'm the one who need not go to his own constituency. So I go to others and help them.
Moving on to a little more national role, how do you see this election panning out as a referendum on Modi and Rahul? You know, after Modi's announcement, a lot of people see this, that there will be the semi-finals.
In the first place, I don't agree that Rahul ji has ever been pitted against Mr. Modi as far as Congress is concerned. Others may be trying to do that, and especially media is trying to project that, but that's not true.
But he is your face. Your best face.
I see no comparison between the two. From day one, Mr. Modi has been a regional leader, a leader of Gujarat, whose success or failures are confined to Gujarat. And from day one, Mr. Rahul Gandhi has been a pan-Indian leader. He is the national leader.
But now they've made him the PM candidate in waiting, so you can't ignore that. Now he's been given national stature.
I think Mr. Modi will have to prove it. He'll have to prove that he can influence elections, say, in these five states, when he visits. Because when he went to Karnataka,
that was already going your way.
He was an utter total failure wherever he went.
But that state was going your way. I mean, he also.
So let's see here. There are so many states being ruled by them. Chhattisgarh is being ruled by them. Gujarat, Madhya Pradesh is being ruled by them. So let's see how much can he affect these elections outside Gujarat. He has not yet proved his utility to the party outside Gujarat.
But do you see Mayawati as a wild card? You know, we are seeing this basically a face-off between BJP and Congress in four of the five states that are going. Is Mayawati the wild card? Because she has a role in every state.
She has a presence in these four states. No denying the fact. She has a presence. But the presence is not as much as it is in Uttar Pradesh.
But here she could be the spoiler or the kingmaker.
Yeah, in a few states she will play that kind of a role.
But then you have a good equation with Mayawati. Would that come into play? Would she be...
In politics, when you belong to two different parties, these kind of personal relations don't count.
You could explain to me about Rahul Gandhi. You know, we have this very reluctant leader. We need a help to understand him. You know, he comes, he makes a comment. It's a shoot and scoot. He'll say, apne government ko nonsense kehke, he'll run away. Then he'll say some Jupiter velocity. I mean, is he engaging us or is he confusing us?
I think... it may take some time to understand him, but having interacted with him in person, I can say that he has the brilliance, he has the vision, and he has the administrative capacity, and more than that, organizational capacity to be the leader of the nation. I see these days, we are all seeing him in regard to how he is dealing with the distribution of tickets, the way he has formalized it, the way he has made it systematic, the way he has removed subjectivity.
How has he organized it? He is asking people to fill forms.
That is just one aspect, but he has gone into scientific surveys, he has taken opinions from various leaders, then he has taken inputs from youth, he has taken inputs from other frontal organizations, and then all are being tabulated, and he is doing it in a very systematic manner. He says if you follow a rule, it should be followed. Don't make exceptions. If he has said that anyone who has lost his Lok Sabha with more than 10,000 or 15,000 votes, come what may, he will not give it to anybody who doesn't come in that category. So he has made it more systematic.
I will let you get away with the statement for now. But the fact is that, you know, he does these things which are very corporate textbook types. You know, have a form, have surveys. At the end of the day, real politics is not about surveys and forms. No? It's about you and me. The real politics is about people, about emotions, about what a personality stands for.
He is not totally removed from real politics. He is interacting with people, he is interacting with leaders, he is going all over, he is going to tribal areas, he is going to the homes of scheduled caste.
These are hit and run visits. So you spend a night, have dinner with a tribal or a Dalit leader, it's not really getting...
He can't be living with them for months together. After all,
but he is doing this discovery of India journey.
To get to know them. You spend a day and the night and it's enough. No other leader does it.
But will he stick to the rule? I remember when Sonia Gandhi came in, one of the first decisions she took and it shocked all of us was that no Rajya Sabha loser, Lok Sabha loser will get a Rajya Sabha ticket, which put an end, if you remember, to Arjun Singh's Rajya Sabha dreams. But uske baad that rule has not really stuck. So will they stick to the rules that Rahul is saying?
As far as I understand Rahul ji, he will stick to the rules. I've seen that happening in Karnataka. I've seen that happening in Gujarat. And I'm seeing that happening in these five states.
But also, supposing the Congress loses all four. You know, Delhi is really is your most crucial state. Every conventional wisdom, you will disagree, has given three states to the BJP. And Delhi is really the only state where, if it is 4-0 the score, then what kind of referendum would that be on Rahul?
Priya, I totally disagree with you. Chhattisgarh would be the first state
to go to Congress. I'm going to catch you on that in December.
That will have a Congress government. and we are hopeful in all the other four states.
So I'll reverse argument. If it is four, if you win all four states, who will you give the credit to?
The credit will go to the leadership and also to all of us, to the Congress workers, to the Congress party, to our
team. Aapko degi party credit.
In Chhattisgarh, in Chhattisgarh, I think we'll all share that credit.
Hmm.
I'll be one amongst them.
Supposing now if you lose all four states, then who gets the blame?
We don't. Politics doesn't run by presumptions.
So you're winning presumption, you're okay with. Yeah. The loss, you're not so happy.
It goes by our assessments.
Hmm.
We don't presume things. We make assessments and we've made assessments. And I don't go beyond Chhattisgarh because I'm not these days having an exposure, all India exposure that I used to have. So I can tell you only about Chhattisgarh. That is, Chhattisgarh is one state which will have a Congress government.
Okay. Finally, the question of Priyanka. You know, we had a rumor that she may be campaigning nationwide, and there was a lot of excitement amongst the party workers. Why isn't she coming? And why isn't she coming?
I don't know why people are bothered about our internal party affairs. She is a part of our party. She is part of our large family of Congress. And as and when she is free or as and when she is asked to, she will help us.
But is the Congress scared she will be a better challenge to Modi than Rahul?
No, why get into this controversy? She is part of us. Mm-hmm. And this is our internal party matter. She'll be most welcome, she'll be used whenever the party wants, whenever Sonia ji wants, whenever Rahul ji wants. She has said it repeatedly, whenever my brother wants, I'll be there. And there is no need for others to bother about this.
But that's the whole problem with the Congress. Leadership takes decision. It's not a democratic party, is it?
No. Ours is a truly democratic party. We at what stage? See, Sonia ji has not become Sonia ji or the Congress president because she is the wife of Rajiv ji, because she married Rajiv ji. She became so because she has been winning elections.
She first became Congress president, then she won an election.
Yeah, whatever, because she always got the mandate. Once she became Congress president, she didn't remain Congress president without going to the people. She went to the people. They gave her a mandate. Same with Rahul ji. He has got people's mandate.
Okay, we're going to end with this and we'll see where the mandate goes for in Chhattisgarh, and hopefully we will talk to you in 2 months' time on that issue.
Thank you, Priya. Thank you.
Thank you.